Hey there, it's Marlene Hielema from ImageMaven.com, and in this video I'm going to talk about focus stacking, specifically for landscape photos using the Lumix G9. Welcome back, subscribers, and if you're new here, thanks for checking me out. You need to know that my overarching goal in my photography, and hopefully yours, is to get things right in the camera. Figure out how to use your camera properly so you spend less time fixing stuff in editing. Heck, if you can get it right in the camera, you have more time to get out and about, to be creative, and to take better pictures. That's what I want for you. So what is focus stacking? Well, focus stacking is a technique that landscape photographers use to get maximum depth of field in their photos. So what they do is they take several photos at different focus points in the scene and combine them after the fact using software. So they have to bring all those photos into the computer and use something like Photoshop to put them together. But with a Lumix camera that has 6K and 4K photo modes, you can actually do all of that in the camera. Now, when you take a photo using post focus or focus stacking, it's the same setting on the camera, in 4K or 6K mode, it actually takes a video file. After your shot is taken, you go into the back of the camera and you choose the focal points that you want the photo to use, and it will combine them right in the camera. You do not have to go into Photoshop to do any of this. I went out yesterday and shot a few landscape photos. Now, just so you know, it's kind of snowy around here still, so they're not stellar photos, but it does demonstrate the technique. All right, let's have a look at the back of the camera and I'll show you how to do this. So before you begin your focus stacking shooting, you have to get into the right mode. So you go into the drive mode here, and you can see there's 6K, and that's the 6K, 4K burst modes, but you go to the one right beside it, and that is the focus stacking and post focus mode. So that's your first step. Okay, the next step, we go into the back of the camera, and you can see here that we have post focus. And you can choose the size 4K or 6K mode. I'll use the 6K mode in here. And all you got to do is push the shutter button and you're going to notice that it recorded in post focus. It went by pretty quickly because, well, I'm shooting a flat surface here. All right, let's check out a photo that I did shoot in post focus mode here. So you can tell that it's the video file because it has this symbol up here. So first off, let's click that symbol there to get into the playback mode. And right now I have focus peaking on, so everything that's in focus is in blue. To take focus peaking off, you just hit that peak. Focus peaking has two different settings, high and low, and then now it's off. So you can just cycle through focus peaking like that. So if we click on the photo, those are the areas that are in focus in our video file. So every frame, it focused on a different area. You can also cycle through using the cursor here and go through your photo, all the corners of your photo, and see what's in focus, and it will bring those in focus. I don't know if you can see it, but I'm going to focus on the background trees, and those came into focus. I'm going to go over to the fence post, and that's in focus. So you can see that different areas of the frame have been shot at different focus points. All right, so if you want to take a photo that's in focus, let's say we want that fence post in focus, you hit this symbol down here in the bottom right corner, and it will save that image, and you hit yes. So right now I just made a 6K photo file from that video. So I extracted one frame from the video. So, but let's say we want to do something else. Let's do some range merging. Let's say I want to have more than one focus point exported and merged together. So let's say I want these in focus, and I'm clicking around the screen, and whatever's green, whatever shows up green, that's what's going to be merged in my photo. So when I'm happy with my areas that I've selected, I hit menu set and you hit yes. Now, depending on how many areas you have chosen, it will take a little bit longer or more or less time. The photo that generated from that has the foreground areas and the areas that I selected in green. Those are now in focus. And actually, let's zoom in and double check. Yep, the trees aren't particularly in focus in this shot, but the fence post and the fence itself is, and some of the other foreground details. So there's our main video file, our 6K video file. So let's do something else with this. So let's go up here and let's do an auto merge. So hit function, auto merging. So auto will take everything that's in focus and stack it. So this is where this comes in and saves you a lot of time. You don't have to do this in Photoshop. It will take everything that's in focus in the series of frames and put them all together in one file. It's not taking just the areas we selected like last time. It's taking every area. So in theory, our trees in the background should also be in focus. So let's zoom in, and sure enough, the trees in the background of this shot are also in focus, and so are the foreground elements, like the fence post. All right, now keep in mind, I shot this at really shallow depth of field, f3.2, and we have a huge distance from foreground to background, so it's doing a really good job of stacking that focus. Let's try a photo that has a bit more extreme focusing on it. Let's play with this one a minute. You can see that I have really close foreground content here and I have background content. So there's quite a huge difference in the distance and the focus in this image. So let's choose some photos. Actually, let's check peaking while we're at it. So you can see the background and see how this area is totally out of focus when we select the background and vice versa. Let's range merge. We want to have this in focus and this in focus. So everything that I've touched is going to be in focus in the green. If you want to take things out, you just click it again if you've got too much. Like if I accidentally put that background in and I don't want it, I can take it off. So you can see that whatever's in green is going to be in focus. And wherever you click is going to have like a harder, darker line around it. But I don't want that and that. I want this up here and this foreground area to be in focus. Whoops, that's a bit too much. Okay, so then we'll use that menu. And so that's selectively choosing what we want in focus. Now this is a 6K file, so it takes a little while to do all that stuff, but it's all being done in the camera. All right, so there's our photo that we just got from this image. Now let's zoom in and you can see that the background is out of focus and the foreground is really in focus sharply. Now let's try to get everything in focus. So we have background and foreground in focus in the same shot. So let's hit function and we're going to do auto merging. So last time we did range merging, this time we're going to do auto merging. Everything that's in focus is going to be put into one photo now. It's all going to be combined in the camera. Okay, so here's our fully merged photo. Let's take a look. Now, I don't know about you, but I see a little problem here. You see this haloing? Because this photo had such a difference in foreground and background focus, it had really shallow depth of field, so the foreground was really blurry. And you can see in here we have a little halo around these thistles. Because of the extreme depth of field in this scene, it's not really a suitable subject for automatically merging. You're much better off manually merging this type of scene. So if we zoom out a bit and we check one of these photos that was done individually. So this is the individual photo of the foreground. There's no gray halos around here because this part was totally sharply in focus and the background completely out of focus. Okay, so in this case, the focus point was on the foreground, so we didn't have this problem with our depth of field. Because in the background, we don't care if it goes blurry, but when you have it in the foreground, it does cause a bit of problem. So you can see how everything in the picture is in focus, but we have this issue with this haloing. A couple of final tips before you go out and shoot your focus stacking landscape photos is you want to probably take a tripod, unlike myself. That was my bad. Shoot with a tripod. Try not to choose a day where it's really windy, especially if you have foreground objects like I did with that thistle photo. You want to have things that don't move and you want to have a tripod. So you don't want your camera to move or your subject to move. Also, if you want more information on post focus in the macro settings, like if you want to use close-ups, you can do some really cool shallow depth of field stuff using post focus as well. I have another video. Check it out. I will put it in the link at the end of the video. Thanks for watching, and please, if you have any questions, let me know in the comments below this video. And just so you know, this video came out of one of the questions that one of you asked me, and I won't embarrass you by saying your name out loud, but you know who you are. Check out all my other Lumix G9 videos and all my other beginners to photography videos, because you know what? I want to help you to take better pictures. That's my goal.